In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of serratus anterior. This muscle is serratus anterior. This muscle is part of shoulder girdle muscles. That means this muscle attaches on scapula. This is very important for scapular movement. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, innervation, and relationship with other muscles. Origin of this muscle is rib cage. It attaches on rib 1 through rib 9. Rib 1 through rib 9. This is very broad muscle. See that? It's such a wide muscle. Okay, this is it. Origin is rib 1 through rib 9. Let's go to insertion. This is posterior view of scapula. This is serratus anterior. This is scapula, by the way. Serratus anterior inserts to anterior surface of scapula. See? This area, particularly around superior angle and medial border. Superior angle and medial border. If I have to say simply, it's on anterior medial part of scapula, around this area. Simple enough, right? Now, let's go to movement. General function of serratus anterior is scapular abduction. Abduction of scapula. Abduction is you bring scapula towards lateral, towards outside. Very important for kind of upper extremity movement. Okay? Abduction is general function. You can divide serratus anterior actually three parts. Upper part, middle part, and inferior part. Middle fiber does abduction. Simple enough, right? Upper fiber is kind of unique. This muscle acts as kind of stabilizer for rotational movement of scapula. Let's say it stabilizes movement. Stabilizing movement. So it becomes like it acts as kind of axis of movement. Sounds very important, right? Upper fiber acts as stabilizing movement, axis of movement. Inferior fiber does upward rotation. Upward rotation is scapula moves this way. Upward rotation, that's inferior fiber. Superior fiber acts as axis of movement. Okay, I shall repeat function. General function is abduction of scapula. Upper fiber acts as axis of movement. Middle fiber does abduction. Inferior fiber does upward rotation. This upward rotation is important for shoulder movement. How come? Because serratus anterior does not attach on humerus. How come it's important for shoulder movement? Okay, when you move shoulder, you know, raising up arm, your scapula needs to move as well. Thus, if scapula doesn't move, shoulder cannot move very much. Okay, scapula and humerus relationship is important thing. And before I go to explain relationship with other muscles, let me explain innervation of this muscle. Okay, innervation of serratus anterior is by this nerve. This is long thoracic nerve. long thoracic nerve. That is from C5 through C7. This nerve runs kind of the midline of lateral part of body. You need to be very careful when you work around this area. Otherwise, you compress long thoracic nerve. That can lead to dysfunction of serratus anterior. Very important place. Okay, this is innervation of serratus anterior. Long thoracic nerve from C5 through C7. Now, let me explain relationship with core muscle. By the way, this is edge of serratus anterior. Kind of zigzag shape, right? And what is this muscle? This muscle shapes like kind of zigzag as well, right? What's this muscle? This is external oblique. External oblique. This is one of core muscles, the outermost core muscle. So this muscle moves core, of course, right? This rotates core and side bends core, and it does flexion. There is myofascial connection between external oblique and serratus anterior. See that? So when external oblique gets tight, maybe serratus anterior can be tight because of this connection. What does it mean? So when your serratus anterior is tight, if you follow myofascial connection, this tightness might affect core movement because of myofascial connection. Vice versa, if external oblique is tight, that can diminish its movement of serratus anterior. This is important myofascial connection, you know. And one more connection, one more relationship. Again, this is serratus anterior. Do you remember general function of serratus anterior? Scapular abduction. An inferior fiber does upward rotation, right? There's one muscle which has completely opposite function. This is rhomboid. Rhomboid. This muscle does scapular adduction and downward rotation. Rhomboid does scapular adduction and downward rotation. Completely opposite, right? When rhomboid doesn't work, maybe serratus anterior does not work. Vice versa, when serratus anterior doesn't work, rhomboid cannot work. This is like a plus minus relationship. You know, yin yang relationship. If either one gets tight, the other one cannot move very well. Serratus and rhomboid relationship is important for scapular movement and stability. Very important connection. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy and function of serratus anterior, plus innervation and relationship with other muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.